Welcome to FightingGators.com. I'm Amanda Wood, back in the swamp with Cody Jones for your rapid recap. The Gators are opening up conference play this weekend. They're taking on Kentucky. Both teams are unranked but have no losses yet. Now let's talk some numbers with Florida. They put up 655 yards of total offense against Eastern Michigan last week. Offensive coordinator Kurt Roper said that they averaged 14 seconds once the ball was snapped on the play clock, but he wants to get that up to 18. Cody, is this something that we should expect from Florida's offense for the rest of the year?
Yeah, you know, I think it's going to be one of the more interesting things to watch as they get into SEC play, because this offense kind of has I think one of the more interesting parts of it is they can go fast or they can kind of slow this thing down a little bit, depending on what pace they get comfortable in. And he said it's kind of the pace that they liked a little bit on Saturday. It was more about just executing on the field before they looked into that kind of stuff. But he said the film did show that there are ways to speed this thing up. Players, when they were tackled, weren't really sure where to throw the ball or to which official, or they were a little slow getting back in position. So I think that's kind of the thing that they'll look at going forward. And when they want to speed this thing up, they've got ways to do it. That the goal, as you mentioned, is 18 seconds on the play clock when the ball snapped. But he even mentioned that there's a couple times on Saturday where it was over 20 at that point. So they can go as fast as they want to, or they can slow it down a little bit too. It's just another little wrinkle to make defenses prepare for.
Now, Kentucky's offense put up just 20 points against Ohio last week, but they showed that they do have talent at the receiver position with sophomore Ryan Timmons and some others. Cody, what do you think this secondary is going to look like against Kentucky?
Yeah, you know, it is a pretty good group of receivers, especially the just playmakers in general. Kentucky, I think, is much improved in those areas. That's something Will Muschamp's talked about. DJ Durkin talked about it today as well. Timmons is a guy Florida actually offered. They like quite a bit out of high school. He wanted to stay home and play for the Wildcats and has had a pretty good season so far. So he'll be the guy, I think, that's the main focus for this secondary. And without J.C. Jackson now, it's a little bit thinner. So you'll see guys like Jalen Tabor and Quincy Wilson probably be the first two off the bench and certainly get plenty of reps as well. So they're going to lean on Hargraves and Poole and the normal veterans back there. But I think it's going to be an interesting storyline to watch how those younger guys handle the first night game in the Swamp, first SEC game before Florida hits the road for Alabama next week.
Now, something that the Gators are pretty concerned about right now is the depth at offensive line. They lost DJ Humphreys, and he's going to be out for a few weeks. Cody, what are we going to see from this offensive line, and what are the concerns right now?
Well, they're going to move Chaz Green over to left tackle from right tackle last week, and Rod Johnson's going to slide in to start at right tackle. I think they feel good about that. Rod Johnson's a guy that they've liked quite a bit since he got here, and now you just throw him in for your first start. You never really know how a guy's going to handle that. So I think that's kind of the issue. The bigger concern is behind him, it's just David Sharp, who's a true freshman. You don't really want to throw that out there at offensive tackle in the SEC. So that's kind of the issue at this point now. They mentioned moving Trenton Brown maybe back out to tackle. He worked there in the spring a little bit, so that'll help the depth a little bit, but they certainly are a little bit more thin there for the next 2 weeks. So they expect to get him back for once they head into the bye week after Alabama, and then certainly back for the Tennessee game. But these next two are kind of be a little bit of a patchwork job at offensive tackle, but they like what Green can do at left tackle. He's worked there a little earlier in his career, and Johnson's a guy they've been high on for the last year or so. So they like what those guys can do. It's just a matter of hoping all these guys stay healthy throughout the game.
All right, well, that's all for your rapid recap. Keep it locked right here on FightingGators.com for all your Gator sports updates. For Cody Jones, I'm Amanda Wood.